Hi guys, first of all, thanks a lot for your awesomeness on the previous video. You were awesome. Huge support from you guys. I really enjoyed your feedback. And because the video was a huge success, I decided to bring this type of video as a series of each video we are going to do with TA. So today is gonna be Vendetta, VNT, fights that were complex, I would say. And I hope you enjoy it too. So if you do, please subscribe, like, share, comment the video. Alright guys, let's look at the positioning of the first push. Melee train of VNT is going to push on our elementalist that is going far away from our melee train. There is a second elementalist, but he will go for our melee train, so they won't push on us. The focus party of VNT is too far away for us to push on them, so we are going to have to push on the VNT melee train to protect our elementalist, to pressure the melee train so they will leave him alone. And that will make the focus party of VNT pushing on the left side of the screen, so they will be able to push on our backline and focus party. Let's start. We push on the mini train and try to pressure on them to leave our M elementalist alone. So we are pushing, bombing here, bombing there, bombing everywhere. And the mini train is still pressing on our elementalist. He will manage to get out right now. He's managing to get out by going to our mini train. One of their DPS warriors is overextending. Our DPS warriors seen him and they are going to go for him. So they will manage to get a kill really easily because their mini train is overextending far too much, trying to pressure our elementalist again. So we're gonna manage to get him down, and because they are too far away they won't be able to get the banner. The banner is going down right now from that DPS warrior over there, and our elementalist is still managing to get out by going through our melee train. Focus party fight over there, one down from each team, so one down from our team and one down from their team. We managed to get a banner on our ally, and they will try to get on the res on that down guy over there, and we are going to pressure on them. That's going to be a huge bomb on the corner. They're going to get banner down on him, but that won't be enough. He's still dead, and we are going to make another pressure now. The next move is going to be very complicated, so let me bring my whiteboard down. Alright, so what do we have here? Our melee train is pressuring on their melee train. Their melee train is really tanky, so we can't manage to get one down. Their focus party is hiding over there, and our focus party and backline is over there. So what they are going to do is to kite us with their melee train, because they know they can tank us, and they can kite us very easily. So their focus party, they have the advantage because they are hiding. They are going to manage to get a kill on our focus party, so because they are not going to be disturbed by our melee train. So like I told you, we are going to pressure on them, the mini train, doing that circular movement, the carousel movement. They are kiting us very well, very fucking tanky. We can't manage to get them down because of the support they have from the elementalists. And now we can see that our backline is in a really bad position. The focus party managed to get one down from our focus party, and we are going to try to help them, try to help that thief over there and the necromancer that is going to get caught. So like I told you, we are going to try to help them. Our backline and focus party. One necromancer is getting caught over here by their melee train. We are going to try to help him. We got one thief dead because of their focus party with that nice kiting move just before. That necromancer get two banners, but he will be trained by their melee train very, very hard, so he won't be able to get out. We will lose another necromancer over here. We are going to try to bomb their melee train one last time because they are so tanky. But we don't manage to get it down, so we are now going to try and bomb the backline. One elementalist over here, we got him, it's a DD like you can see. We will manage to get an immobilize on him now, and we can now bomb him hard. The ammunition is moving away and coming back too slow because we managed to get the kill. And we are going to help our focus party on their backline over here, fight very far away from both melee trains. So we are going to manage to get move as soon as possible, but we are too late to get that elementalist to court him. So he's going to manage to get away by going through their melee train like this. We need to go back now to help our DPS warrior getting caught by their melee train. We managed to get a banner on him. Our necromancer is getting caught on the left side of the screen. One thief is getting caught in front of the screen. On the right side, their melee train is still pressuring the DPS warrior. The necromancer is dead. We managed to get the res on both DPS warrior and the thief, helping our DPS warrior to get out of their melee train by pressuring them on their melee train. That's it, over there we have a focus party and a DPS warrior fight against the focus party of the NT. We managed to get that elementalist, we've seen him is far away from everything, so we are going to get him down. The melee train is too far away to get a banner once again, too far extended, so we are going to kill that elementalist very fast. And our DPS warriors managed to get another elementalist on the left side of the screen now, here over here, so that's 3 elementalists dead. That's it, we can manage to kill him. And our focus party managed to get another one down over here. We are going to try and help him finish him fast, regrouping, and trying to bomb the melee train, but they're moving fast away from the bomb. We managed to get another necromancer over here on the right side. Finish him fast. They can't banner him anymore, but we are going to punt for they not going to res manual res. Before that necromancer, their bomb will be weak and they will have no support because we killed almost all the elementalists. So we are going to try and pressure the melee train, and with that long pressure on them, they will down. So that's it for the first round, guys. And let's start the round. First static going now. Veiling in front. And we have an amazing positioning for the first push, like you can see. Beautiful positioning. And this is where things are getting complicated. Melee train from VNT is pushing on the left side. We are going to move for their focus party. So melee train of VNT is going to push for our backline. We will need to get to the focus party and come back to help our backline as soon as possible. We also have one down from them, so we can kill him fast before moving for their focus party. Melee train is pushing and we can move for the focus party, scattering them, making them shield their burns with some pulls, and pulling back to help our backline. They still managed to get one down from us. We tried to banner him, but he's dead. We have two downs of them from our focus party and DPS warriors. We can try to kill also a melee train, a warrior. He will rally bot one of our necromancer that was caught behind. And now we can move on that necromancer in front. Very easy kill. Amazing immobilize on him. Another melee train down. Guardian is dead. And now we can pressure on their melee train and all the rest of their guild. Our focus party managed to get one down behind, a melee train one down in front. This elementalist finishing fast, focus party is also finishing theirs. Another down on the right side, bombing on him. One of our guys is getting caught by their melee train, so we are going to push hard on them and bannering him. And under this kind of pressure, they can't handle it. They are getting caught one by one, downing and dying one by one. And with that beautiful last pressure, guys, that's it for today. Two rounds against Vendetta, VNT.